Published, 7 o'clock Eastern Daylight Saving Time, the 31st of March 2018. Updated, 11:49 Eastern Daylight Saving Time, the 31st of March 2018. Stephen Hawking's family said their final goodbyes today, as thousands lined the streets Cambridge for the funeral of the renowned theoretical physicist, who died peacefully at his home earlier this month, despite having said he is an atheist. Professor Hawking's family, including ex-wife Jane Hawking, son Timothy Hawking and daughter Lucy Hawking, who were pictured leaving the church in tears, felt that traditional Anglican service would give his many friends in the city a chance to pay tribute to him. The service was held at Great St. Mary's Church, a stone's throw from Gonville and Caius College, where he was a fellow for 52 years, and saw Eddie Redmayne, who portrayed Professor Hawking in the Hollywood biopic The Theory of Everything, give a reading from the Bible entitled Everything Has Its Time. Scroll down for video. The service is being held at Great St. Mary's Church, a stone's throw from Gonville and Caius College, where Professor Hawking was a fellow for 52 years. Since his death at home earlier this month, thousands of people have visited this college to sign his book of condolence. Actor Eddie Redmayne seated left 7 rows back waiting for the service to begin. Professor Hawking's family, including ex-wife Jane Hawking, near right, son Timothy Hawking, middle right, and Lucy Hawking, far right, felt that traditional church service would give his many friends in the city a chance to remember and pay tribute to him. Crowds lined the streets to pay their final respects to the much-admired scientist, and a spontaneous round of applause broke out as 6 porters from the physicist's former college carried his coffin from the hearse into the church. The bell tolled 76 times for the physicist, one for every year of his life. Redmayne was among the first to arrive earlier in the day. Well, Felicity Jones, who starred alongside him in The Theory of Everything, followed shortly after. She made her way into the church hand-in-hand with fiancé film director Charles Gard. The Birmingham actress, 33, has also starred in Star Wars and studied at Oxford University. Redmayne gave an emotional reading at Professor Hawking's funeral, with Ecclesiastes 3:1-11 as the chosen text. This was followed by a reading by the Astronomer Royal, Martin Rees. Eulogies were delivered by Robert Hawking, Professor Hawking's eldest child, and Professor Faye Dowker, a former student of Professor Hawking. His ashes will be interred next to the grave of Sir Isaac Newton at Westminster Abbey and near Charles Darwin's. Professor Hawking's ashes would be interred next to the grave of Sir Isaac Newton at Westminster Abbey. Eddie Redmayne was among the first to have arrived in Cambridge for the funeral of renowned theoretical physicist Professor Stephen Hawking, who died at home on March 14, prompting an outpouring of grief around the world. Former Cambridge student Redmayne played Professor Hawking in the Hollywood biopic of his life, and the pair became firm friends during the filming. Actor Eddie Redmayne, who gave a reading, seated 7 rows back before the service began. Stephen Hawking's children, Lucy, Robert and Tim, said in a statement, "Our father lived and worked in Cambridge for over 50 years. He was an integral and highly recognizable part of the university and the city. For this reason, we have decided to hold his funeral in the city that he loved so much and which loved him. Our father's life and work meant many things to many people, both religious and non-religious. So, the service will be both inclusive and traditional, reflecting the breadth and diversity of his life," the Dean of Westminster, the Very Reverend Dr. John Hall, said. "It is entirely fitting that the remains of Professor Stephen Hawking are to be buried in the Abbey, near those of distinguished fellow scientists. Sir Isaac Newton was buried in the Abbey in 1727. Charles Darwin was buried beside Isaac Newton in 1882. Redmayne gave a reading at Professor Hawking's funeral, with Ecclesiastes 3:1-11 as the chosen text. For everything there is a season, Hawking pictured at home, 1954, everything has its time. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to throw away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to throw away, a time to tear, and a time to sow, a time to keep silence, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace. The God-given task, what gain have the workers from their toil? I have seen the business that God has given to everyone to be busy with. He has made everything suitable for its time. Moreover, he has put a sense of past and future into their minds, yet they cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end, despite having said he is an atheist. Professor Hawking's family, including wife Jane Hawking, left, son Timothy Hawking, center, and daughter Lucy Hawking, right, felt that traditional church service would give his many friends in the city a chance to remember and pay tribute to him. Jane Hawking, second right, the first wife of Professor Stephen Hawking and their children, Timothy, left, and Lucy, center, attend his funeral at University Church of St. Mary the Great in Cambridge. Lucy Hawking, left, and Timothy Hawking, right, overcome with emotion following the service. Other famous scientists are buried or memorialized nearby, the most recent burials being those of atomic physicists Ernest Rutherford in 1937 and Joseph John Thomson in 1940. We believe it to be vital that science and religion work together to seek to answer the great questions of the mystery of life and of the universe. Professor Hawking died on March 14th at the age of 76, after a lifetime as one of the world's most renowned scientists, despite his battle with motor neurone disease, prompting an outpouring of grief from around the world. Crowds lined the streets to pay their final respects to the much-admired scientist, and a spontaneous round of applause broke out as six porters from the physicist's former college carried his coffin from the hearse into the church. Professor Stephen Hawking's coffin carried into Church of St. Mary the Great, watched on by friends, family and admirers. Viv Riches, one of Professor Hawking's former carers, broke down in tears as his coffin was carried into the church. Mourners gather outside King's College, Cambridge, as the funeral cortege of British physicist Stephen Hawking passes by. En route to Great St. Mary's Church, family and friends of Professor Hawking pictured seated during the church service. Felicity Jones, who starred alongside Redmayne, has also made her way into the church hand in hand with fiancé film director Charles Gard. The Theory of Everything actress, 33, has also starred in Star Wars and studied at Oxford University in The Theory of Everything. Jones played Professor Hawking's wife, Jane Hawking. Charles Gard has previously directed 2009's The Uninvited model. Lily Cole pictured walking into the service in upbeat floral ensemble. Queen guitarist Brian May pictured outside Great St. Mary Church as Lily Cole makes her way indoors. Stars align: Redmayne, Lily Cole, Felicity Jones, and Charles Gard.